The second example is this one, exercise 11.4. We have the figure shows a small sphere as of mass 0.5 kilogram. So this one is 0.5 kilogram, mounted on a 0.6 kilogram uniform rope. So you have two components. The first one is this one, 0.5 kilogram, and the rope itself is 0.6 kilogram. So now you have two mass. And pivoted at A, okay, and supported at end B by a vertical spring. So you have one spring here, okay. The system start from rest. So you have to take this information. Start from rest, okay, meaning that the velocity at the position 1 is 0. With the spring stretch 0.1, this information, we know that x1 equal to 0.1 stretch, so positive 0.1. Determine the spring stiffness K if the rod is required to move with an angular velocity of 5 radian over second. The instant rod AB reach vertical position. Okay, so you have to find the value of K. Okay, in this example, from this example, the position 1 and 2 is already drawn for you. But in this one, it is not drawn, so you have to draw it yourself. Okay, so this is the position 1 and position 2 from the question. Okay, so from the question, we have position 1 and position 2. Okay, so it's position 1 and position 2. Okay, so the spring is attached here, so you have the length, all the length is given. Okay, so you are required to find what is the value of K. So, taken from here, MB is 0.5, the small one, B, I call it this, a B, and the rod is 0.6 kilogram. Okay, start from rest, V1 equals 0, omega equal to 0. Stress 0.1, so x1 is 0.1. We're required to find K when the omega is 5 radian over second. Okay, so from this position, you know that you will use the I. Okay, so in here I directly calculate the value of I for IB here. Okay, because this is small, the radius is not given, so IB will be I for component B will be 0. The IR, looking from this direction, it will be ms squared divided by 12. So you put the value, you have the answer. Okay, so come up to the equation. You use always the same equation. U12 equal to delta VG12 plus delta VE12 plus delta T12. Okay, so check one by one. There is no constant force, there is no cable, friction is not stated. No couple, so you want to equal to 0. Okay, if there's couple, you put couple. If there's cable, so you put cable. So in this case, it is 0. Okay, so delta VG, MG delta H. Okay, so notice here, MG delta H, this is MG delta H. I have two components, MG delta H for the first component, the ball, the B ball, and MG delta H for the rod. Okay, if you have three, you should add another, the other one. So now we have two, so you put 2. Okay, so M for the ball, G, and this is the delta H. So delta H you have to calculate from here. Okay, so this is the delta H 1 moving downwards, so with negative, the length here is 0.45, so the 0.45. so, and delta H for the second one, this is 0.45 plus 0.15 divided by 2, so we have this one, so because it is here moving. This is the G from first position, G from second position of the second component. So this is the road, so the delta H is from the G. So G from first position, G from second position, so this is delta H2. Okay, so it's negative 0.3. So you calculate that one, you have negative 3.997. Now we go to delta VE12 equations, x minus this one. So given the x1 is 0.1, the L you can given the length 0.5, so you can calculate the value of L. Okay, so from this L, you know the L, and then from position 2, the L2 is this length. This is the L2. Now you know the value of L, so L2 minus the L, you have the X2. Okay, so L2 minus L, you have the X2. Here, X2. And then you put in the equation X2 minus X1 squared. So you have the K is the one that you need to know. Okay, the last part is delta V, delta T12. Okay, so delta T12 equal to T2 minus T1. It is said that, T2 minus T1 for both components. So T2 minus T1 for the ball and T2 minus T1 for the road. So you have to, if you have three components, you have to add the third one. Okay, but it is said that it is released from rest, the T1 for both part will be 0. Okay, so it leaves you only T2 for the ball and T2 for the road. Okay. Okay, so this one, this first one is for the ball, and the second one is for the road. So the equation is half mv squared plus half I omega squared. This one I make it 0 because the I is 0. Okay, the I is 0. Okay, not the omega. The omega is there, but the I is 0. So this whole thing becomes 0. So for the road, the whole component is there. There's not a 0. Okay, so now you see that you have VB, V ball, and VR, and omega. There is three unknown, three components. But the one that you know is the omega R. So you can transfer the V in term of using the omega. Okay, the VB also using the omega. Okay, this is R, which is from, this is from the ball towards the pivot point, 0.45. This is the middle point, which is the center of gravity towards the pivot point, the R. So you can transfer the V in term of with the omega. So you have the value. The V is given, the R is not given. So you can calculate the value of R. Okay, so you put all this one inside this equation. Okay, put the known value. Okay, this part, just put it all, and then you get the delta T1S, this one, and put it in the original equation, and you have one unknown here, so you get the answer. Okay.